In this lesson, we're going to take a look at project files in Autodesk Inventor. To start with, I'm going to create a new project file. From the Get Started tab, I'll just simply select Projects. I can browse to find an existing one, but once more I'm going to click New to create a new one. I can create a single user project, or if I'm using Vault to collaborate with others, I can select that option as well. Next, I will give it a name. I'm just simply going to name mine Practice. Then I will give it a location to set as the workspace. This is where Inventor is going to look for all of the parts when I'm opening up assemblies or drawings. I'm going to select the location where my files are located. I can click Next. If I have additional libraries to add to my project, I can do so. If not, I will go ahead and click Finish. Now you can see that this is the active project. Now let's take a look at some of the settings of this project. First, we'll look at the workspace. Once again, this is set to where my files are stored at that I just did inside the wizard. When I expand the workspace, whenever I see the little period here, that's indicating a relative reference. So it's basically the current folder. If I wanted to, I could select the workspace, then the pencil, and edit this to change this to another location. Similarly, I can add libraries. If I have some components maybe that my company has created and I want to be able to access those when I'm working with assemblies, I can select libraries, then the plus, and then I can go ahead and browse to that particular library. Here I'll go ahead and select this catalog and then click OK. And then I can give it a more specific name. For example, if they were electrical components, I might call this my electrical library or something along those lines. I can continue adding library paths as needed. I'm going to expand the options item here, and we can see a few of the different items that we can change here. We can put in some default information for the owner, for example, and I can also adjust the number of old versions to keep. I'm going to select this and edit it. By default, Autodesk Inventor creates an old versions folder inside your workspace, and it saves one backup copy. I can adjust this number and have it save as many files as I would like. The larger the number, the more versions I can go back to. The downside, of course, is going to be the file size that's taken up by saving so many files. As you can see, I can set this to -1, and it will save all backup copies. I will go ahead and click Done, and then Yes to save my changes. I'm going to open up an assembly now. And as you know by now, an assembly is just simply links to part files, and sometimes we'll open up an assembly and it can't find one or more of the parts. Once again, this is one of the things the project file will help with. It'll tell Autodesk Inventor where to look for components. For now, I'm going to go ahead and skip this problem and click OK to work in an assembly with an unresolved component. As we look over here in the model browser, you can see that I have one part that is unresolved. It couldn't be found. I'm going to right-click on the assembly name and select Resolve File. It's important to note that you right-click on the assembly name, not on the missing component. This brings back the same dialog box we saw when we were opening the assembly. This will allow me to either locate that component or select a component to take its place. I'm going to go ahead and select the slider in this case, then click Open. As you can see, it has now been replaced in the assembly, and since it was pretty much the same component but with a different name, it recognized all of the different constraints and placed it properly. It's important to note that you cannot change projects while you're inside of a file. So you must close any open files before returning to projects and setting another one current. So in my case, I'm going to double click on my intro to modeling to return to that project file. That concludes this look at working with Autodesk Inventor project files.